Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics, and in this video we will see the difference between microprocessor and the microcontroller. So visually, if you see any microcontroller or a microprocessor, there is hardly any difference between them. They almost look very identical, but they are different in many aspects. They are different in terms of the applications in which they are used. They are different in terms of the cost. They are different in terms of the processing power which they possesses, and they are different in terms of the power consumption. So today we will see the difference between the microprocessor and the microcontroller based on all these aspects. So first let us see the difference between them in terms of the applications in which they are used. So the classic example of a microprocessor application is a personal computer or a laptop. So using this laptop we can do a lot of stuff. Like we can use it for the gaming, for web browsing, for photo editing, for creating documents, or we can use it for mathematical calculations, simulations, or a media streaming. So a microprocessor is basically used in applications where task is not predefined. It depends upon the user, or it is used in applications where the intensive processing is required. While in case of a microcontroller, they are used for a specific task. So based on the inputs which are given to the microcontroller, it do some processing and it gives the result as a output. So here the inputs could be a user inputs or the inputs which are coming from the sensors. So the examples of a microcontroller applications are like digital camera, washing machine, and a microwave oven. So if you see all these devices, the task which is going to be performed is predefined. Like in case of a microwave oven, once you set the power and the timing, it gives you the cooked food. Likewise, in the case of a washing machine, once you set the parameters of the machine, it gives you the clean and dry clothes. So basically, a microcontroller is used in applications where task is predefined. Now let us see the difference between them in terms of the internal structure. So like I said earlier, the microprocessors are used in applications where task is not predefined. So they can be used for a very light application like creating a documents, or very intensive application like a gaming or a media streaming. So the amount of memory that is required depends upon the application. So if you see a microcontroller chip, it only contains a CPU, which is central processing unit. And all the memory elements and the IO interfaces are connected to it externally. So in case of a microprocessor, the memory elements like RAM, ROM, IO ports, serial interface, and the timers all are connected externally. While in case of a microcontroller, as they are used for a specific task, the amount of memory and the IO ports which are required are limited. So in the case of a microcontroller, all the memory elements and IO ports are integrated along with the CPU inside a single chip. So the size of a overall system is much smaller. While in case of a microprocessor, as all the memory elements and the IO ports are connected externally, so overall size of the system is larger than the microcontroller. Now let us see the difference between microcontroller and microprocessor in terms of the processing power and the memory. So microprocessors are operated at a much higher speed. So if you see the clock speed of a microprocessors, it is in the range of gigahertz. The clock speed varies from a 1 GHz to the 4 GHz for the high-end processors. So as a microprocessor has to run an operating system, the amount of memory, that is RAM and ROM, which is required is quite high. So if you see the random access memory or a RAM, which is a volatile memory in the microprocessor, it ranges from a 512 MB and it goes up to the 32 GB in a high-end microprocessors. Similarly, if you see the ROM in the microprocessor, it ranges from the 128 GB and it goes up to the 2 TB, that is a 2 terabyte. And the common peripheral interfaces which you see in the microprocessors are like USB, high speed Ethernet, and the UART. While in the case of a microcontroller, the clock speed is in the range of megahertz. So if you see the clock speed of a microcontrollers, it ranges from the 1 megahertz and it goes up to the 300 megahertz in the high-end microcontrollers. And as these microcontrollers are defined for a specific task, the amount of memory that is required by them is quite less. So if you see a random access memory or a RAM inside the microcontroller, it is in the range of kilobytes. So it can go from the 2 kilobyte up to the 256 kilobytes. Similarly, if you see a flash memory or a program memory inside a microcontroller, it varies from the 32 kilobyte and it can goes up to the 2 megabytes. And the common peripheral interfaces which you find inside the microcontroller are like I2C, SPI and the UART. So basically all these are serial interfaces which you find in a modern day microcontrollers. So if you see a modern day microprocessors, they are either a 32 bit or a 64 bit. So a 32 bit microprocessor means a microprocessor can handle a 32 bits of binary data at the same time. Similarly, a 64 bit microprocessor can handle a 64 bits of data at a same time. So in case of a 64 bit microprocessor, all the address bus and the database are of a 64 bits. Similarly, in the case of a 32 bit microprocessor, the address and the data bus are of a 32 bits. While if you see a modern day microcontrollers, they are either of 8 bit, 16 bit or a 32 bits. So the amount of data which can be handled by a microprocessor in a single cycle is higher than the microcontrollers. Now let us see the difference between the microcontroller and microprocessor in terms of the power consumption and the cost. So in case of a microprocessor, as all the memory elements and the IO ports are connected externally, the overall cost of the system as well as the power consumption is higher compared to the microcontrollers. So this is a summary of the differences between the microprocessor and a microcontroller based on the various parameters which we have already discussed. The downloadable link for the same is given in the description below, so you may check that out. So before I end up this video, one more thing which I want to tell you is that you might have observed that when I was discussing about the applications of the microprocessor, I had given the example of a personal computer, but I didn't mention anything about the smartphone. But if you see the smartphone, it can do almost all the things which a personal computer can do. Like you can play a games, you can do a web browsing, you can create documents, etc. in the smartphone. But still it is not an example of a microprocessor, because the chip that you find inside the smartphone is neither a microprocessor nor a microcontroller. It is sort of a combination of a both thing, and it is known as a system on chip or a SoC. So we will discuss about it more in the upcoming videos. So I hope in this video you understood the differences between the microprocessors and the microcontroller. If you have any questions or suggestions, please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.